So, welcome to my new video, that is the technical fundamental analysis, sorry. So, the fundamental analysis, we will be studying about the price to book ratio today. So, we studied about the price to earnings ratio. Now, we will be studying about the price to book ratio. So, what is actually the book value? So, book value means is the tangible assets. So, tangible assets minus the total liabilities is called the book value. So, what is book value? Book value means the tangible assets minus the total value or the total liabilities actually. So, what is asset and liability? That is the most important thing you need to know first. So, asset. Asset means a substance whose value increases with time. So, for example, like I have bought a car, for example. Okay. So, if I sell the car next year, I have bought the car for, say, 1 lakh. If I sell the car next year, it will be getting sold for 80,000. If I sell it again next year, it will get sold for 70 or 60,000. So, the price of the car reduces every year. So, I cannot sell the car for the same price that I bought it for. So, the car is a liability for me. The money that I spent on the car keeps on degrading. So, that is called liability. So, if I buy liability, so we buy toy, we may buy computer, whatever products we buy, almost most of them are liabilities. Their value keeps on going down with time. So, that is called liability. So, it is not profitable. Something that you buy, which is a loss for you in the future, is called a liability. An asset. For example, I bought a land. If I buy a house, if I buy a property, all that is an asset. Because when I sell the land or the house, the price of the land will be more than I bought it for now. So, if I bought a land for 1 lakh, the price of the land after a year might be 1.2 lakh. So the price might increase based on the situation. So, that is called an asset. Asset is a useful thing. It gives us profit. It makes you earn. So, you can sit at a place and earn if you have a lot of assets. Assets gives you money. Liability takes off your money. So, book value means the total number of tangible assets, means the assets that the company has permanently. Okay. So, the assets minus the total liabilities, whatever is the total losses, loss making products. So, the company might have internet connection. The company might have bought a router. They have to pay money for the internet connection every month. So, that is a liability for the company. The money keeps going every month. And for example, the company has bought a system. So, the system will get damaged after a month or year. Then you have to change it. So, that is a liability. But asset means, for example, the land that the company bought. Or for example, the company has bought a product whose value will increase. The product is making money for the company. If you buy a substance which makes money for you. For example, internet connection can also be a liability. Sorry, it can also be an asset. If you have an internet connection and your internet connection is a source of income for you, internet connection pays you, you're using the internet connection wisely and you're getting money from it, it becomes an asset. So, asset means something that gives you money. For example, vehicle is a liability. As I told you, vehicle is liability because when I sell it, its price depreciates. Depreciates means it goes down. Or I have to keep putting fuel in my vehicle, right? If I buy a vehicle, I have to put petrol. So, the petrol is an extra expense. So, the vehicle is a liability. But what if my vehicle is giving me money every month? If I appoint a driver for my vehicle and if the vehicle gives me a lot of money, if I'm renting my vehicle, the vehicle becomes an asset. If I rent my vehicle to somebody, the vehicle becomes an asset. I get money every month from the vehicle. So, the vehicle is an asset. And then you earn more money from the vehicle than you bought it for. So, that is an asset. Asset means something that gives you money. But liability means something that drains your money. So, book value means the total number of assets the company has minus the liability. So, it is basically like a profit. Something that makes profit for the company. If you remove the loss-making product from the total number of profit-making product, it means the company is good. Because in long term, the company will keep making profit. Because the thing which was making the loss has been subtracted. After that, the value that you get will be a profit-making value. Right. So, that is the book value. Book value means a value which is actually profit-making value. How much profit the company will be making in the future. Because it is the asset. It is the total number of remaining asset. If you remove the liabilities from the assets, subtract. So, what will be the net profit-making substance? That is called the book value. So, this is the book value definition. Now, what is price to book value? So, market cap divided by the book value is the price to book value. So, whatever I told you was the whatever ratios I taught you were all divided by the market cap, right? So, same way, market cap divided by the book value is called the price to book value. And share price divided by the book value per share can also be called as the book value. So, this is the same concept. As I told you, price per share, right? Book value per share. So book value divided by share. So if the divided by share goes up and get multiplied by price, share price, it becomes market cap, right? So number of outstanding shares. So this is the price to book value. So if the price to book value is low, for example, so it means the price of the share is less and price book value is more. Book value per share is more, but the share price is less. So it means the company is profitable. Book value is something very important. If book value is more, it means the company is good. So if the book value is more, that means the price of the share is less. And if the price of the share is less compared to its book value, you must buy the company, right? So price to book value is less, the company is profitable. And if price to book value is more, the company is loss making. So it can also be called as market cap. That is the total number of shares into the share price divided by the book value. This is also the this one. Now, how do we use the price to book value? I told you all the ratios and I'm also telling you how to use those ratios. So here, low price to book value, as I told you, means a company is undervalued. The company is not given so much value. It's not been bought by so many people. That's why the price of the company is low. So what you must do, you must buy the share. If the price to book value is low, it means that the book value is more, right? If the price to book value is low, it means book value is more and the price is less. So the company is undervalued. If the price is low than the company deserves it, it is called undervalued. So low price to book value means that the company is undervalued and it is a profitable company. You must buy it. So you can look for the price to book value and decide whether the company is good or bad. High price to book value means that the company is overvalued because the price of the share company is more than the book value. So compare different companies and see their book values. If the book value is low, buy it. If the book value is high, don't buy it. You can sell it. So this is how you decide whether you have to buy a company. Based on the ratios that I told you. Price to earnings ratio was again a very important factor, right? If the earnings of the company is more or less, if the price to earnings ratio is less, it means the company is earning more than the price of the share you can buy. So make a list of different ratios and make your own strategy. I'm teaching you these ratios so that you can make your own strategy. You can decide what has to be given first priority. If price to share ratio is more or price to earning ratio is more, whatever you feel is more important parameter for you, have it on the top. Next, go for what you look for next in the company. Why do you have the share for long term? If you want the share to have a good price to book value in the future, so make a list and create your own strategy how to buy and sell the share. So this is the price to book value. Now you learned the different types of ratios. We learned different ratios which you can see in the playlist. I have linked it. So price to book value is one of the important ratios. Now just go ahead. And if you haven't seen my playlist, do watch the playlist, because for long-term investors, this is very important. And why long-term investing is important, I will definitely make another video on that, how useful long-term investing is, so that you don't underestimate the long-term investing advantages. So long-term investing is like an asset. Share is an asset for you. As I told you, tangible assets minus the book value, right? So if you have more number of assets, you are safe. Just like how the company is safe, if it has a lot of assets, your future is safe if you have a lot of assets. So shares of the companies are generally assets. Shares of good companies basically are assets for you. So if you buy a lot of shares, in the future you will be making a lot of income. And definitely, to do long-term investment or to do trading, for both, you need a DMAT account, which I have given in the description. So the first step, as I told you, in every video I'm telling, if you haven't still created a DMAT account, definitely create a DMAT account in the description. And really, thank you very much for watching the video. Comment down your opinions about the video, how I can improve the video, and what you expect from the video. How do you expect it to be? So do comment it and like and share the video and subscribe to the channel. Would be